Yeah, let's do that. It'll be down in the house. Go ahead.
2, 1. 2, 1, 1, 1. 2, check. 2, 1.
Yeah.
Come on top, John. Yeah. I got a lot of monitors in myself.
I mean, all I need is something to plug in. I have a DI. 4, 1.
We formed Suddenly Tammy about 4 years ago, I guess 1989. And I had just moved home from Boston, and I got together with Ken, and we kind of messed around with the piano that was in his basement.
Very out of tune.
Yeah, very out of tune. And he put a few bass ideas along with a couple of things that I had been working on, and we thought it was the beginning of a band. So then we thought that we should probably get drums, because then it would really rock. So we called Jay, and he just never showed up for a rehearsal for the band that he was in currently, and sort of became the drummer.
I kind of moved over to a different band, and here I was.
We are all from Lancaster.
Yes. Those two are from the same home.
Yeah,
originally.
This is my brother.
We're siblings.
Yeah. Brother and sister and not brother.
That's right.
But adopted.
At this point, practically.
Adopted through the world of magic of music.
Right.
He's not rational. You sit down, bed. Oh.
much more comfortable than that other thing. It feels like metal. Feels cold as metal. Inside them frozen from head to foot, sled tracks cut through the edges. I gave him time to melt down, and it's so dark in here, so cold all along, so wet on the edges, and frozen from head to foot, he's melting. He's not rational, you sit down, bed on the floor. They'd say it's much more comfortable than that other thing. It feels like metal. Tracks cut through the edges. I gave him time to melt down, and it's so dark in here, so cold all along, so red on the edges, and frozen from head to foot, he's melting.
I would say that in the fact that our music is certainly not what you would consider sort of like urban music, you know, it's not part of the heavy like dance scene or something like that. It's kind of more music that came from what we listened to early on in our homes as children.
And our upbringing in school. We were all part of our local, actually high school, junior high school orchestras, bands, choruses.
Plays, so, musicals.
Plays and musicals and stuff like that. So we all knew each other from that stuff. Jay and I were both in the percussion section when I was a senior in high school.
Marching band.
Kenny was played upright bass in the orchestra. So we've always had that experience of playing with other musicians. So I think that helps us in our band, because we have to listen to each other and not overplay, not play too much over top of someone else's part.
And also, you know, try to enhance each other's parts with the parts we play. I think once in a while someone will give us a comment that our music is almost jazz-like, which probably sounds strange to some people, but I think in the fact that when jazz musicians play, they play off of each other by listening, you know, closely and either imitating or complimenting. I think that's where that sort of comparison comes from.
Our sound, everyone asks us about that, how we would describe our sound, and I never know what to say. I always say it's piano, bass, drums, and a vocal, if you can imagine what that would sound like. And people say, well, is it alternative, or
a lot
are you
of people
rock and
think
roll,
it's a jazz combo when they hear that as well.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. How about you? What would you say?
I've never been able to define it very well. You know, people ask me what we sound like. You know, name a group, and I don't know really.
Why there are no guitars? It wasn't a matter of leaving them out, or having them and then kicking them out. It was just that when we got together, we liked the way it sounded with the instruments that we had, so we never even thought of having a guitar. Other people asked us, you know, you should add a guitar, then it would really sound, you know, really rock. I was like, yeah, maybe, but this is enough for us, and we thought that people would enjoy that kind of instrumentation in a different format. Say enough about WXPN and WDRE also, but first I think WXPN sort of shouldered the cause. We went to do a World Cafe show, and on the way down the steps to put our stuff back in our cars, Mike Morrison, the station manager, said, "Why don't you hand me your CD? I'll pick a cut and we'll play it on the radio." But we didn't know he was going to put it into heavy rotation.
Every day.
So it was. I was getting phone calls that week, and then weeks following, saying, "I hear you guys on the radio all the time," and then WDRE, they picked it up, and they had a Shriek of the Week thing,
right,
where people have to actually call in
and scream
and vote for their a song of a list of songs, and we won that Shriek of the Week. My mom calls it Squeak of the Week, so that's okay too. But so we were Squeak of the Week for a week.
Watch me grow. You're taking me for the ride. Spin me when you are ready to dance. Spin me when you are ready to dance. And write it down in blood. Do you have any idea what they doing outside? Plant me and watch me grow. You're taking me for a ride. Watch me grow. You're taking me for a ride. Spin me when you are ready to guess. Spin me when you are ready to guess. And write it down in blood. Do you have any idea what they're doing?
Usually, well, in the past, a lot of the songs have come from Beth you know, we'd get together, come to a practice. Beth would have an idea or part of an idea, then we'd all kind of get together. A lot of times she'd have a finished song, and Kenny and I would just kind of add our two cents. More recently, like, we're all taking, you know, more of an equal role, you know, doing things. At least that's what we're, you know, trying to do, because it's nice to have the differences mm-hmm. in everybody's style and what they're looking for in a song.
Songwriting has been different for a lot of different songs have changed since we first got together, but the songwriting method is different for every song, because sometimes I'll have an idea and I'll play it and it will be like a finished phrase or something, and then you'll play a drum part and it will change my mind altogether.
The songs change as each
or
of
he'll
us
do that.
Puts our own, you know, characteristic playing style into it.
Signed with Warner Brothers, and the thing that it ensures us is that we can make a record and another record, and that we'll probably play those songs out in public for people. Other than that, it's really going to be taking it as it comes, and we really want to try to make the best, most musical, enjoyable records that we can make. Using our resources that we have.
And continuing to do it ourselves as far as, you know, artistic choices and, you know, continuing the self-sufficiency that we've had in the past, but now we have this wonderful resource of really talented people who just want to help with the music because they like the music we've already made, and, you know, that group of people is Warner Brothers Records, and I think it's going to work out really well for us to make records with them.
Yeah, I don't think too much is going to really change. I mean, I don't think we really feel differently. We feel excited because of the opportunities that are available to us now.
Well, it's just like when you buy a record and you put it on and it makes you feel like, wow, this is a great record. And a lot of those great records that we have are from, you know, our Warner Brothers artists. So the notion of being part of that is exciting to us, but we have a job to do now. We have to make the record and perform it. So we are up to the task, I think, and we're really looking forward to that opportunity.
See ya.